another body ballet for you today. Stood on something. I'm going to go straight in. I'm going to warm up with pliés. We're going to start with some demi-pliés, pushing into the balls of the feet, rotating from the tops of the legs. I'm going to press into one foot, then the other. We're going to add some side bends. Then we're going to do the same thing in second position, and then we're going to take the feet parallel, either together or hip distance apart. We're going to hinge from our hips because we're still warming up. Take the arms all the way down. So start with the knees soft. By this time, we would have done quite a few bend stretches, work through the legs a bit, and start to send the hips up and down and up and down, sending our core up. You don't have to be able to straighten your legs, don't worry. And then adding some rise and lower. So if you need to take your hands to something rather than because you can't reach the floor, then that's okay for the rises. Anyone's got low blood pressure, do the same thing but standing, okay? Oh, but otherwise it'll feel really nice to have to open the back and the backs of the legs as well. I think that's it. Just gonna go for it. I will of course quickly mention our posture. I'll do that on the intro. That's what intros are for. Ah, here we go. Nice, so standing tall, from the tops of your legs, really turn out so you're squeezing these muscles together in at the back. So you're gonna feel the inside thighs working, the glutes working. Now, send your tailbone down, lift your pelvic floor, lift your navel. Imagine zip up at the front, zip down at the back. One of my dance teacher friends told me that this week. Zip up, zip down, shoulders are down. Put your hands to the waist. Demi-pliés, down. Push into the balls of the feet to come up. Engage those inside thighs. Keep these top muscles working. Rotating round. Rotating, rotating. Lifting, holding. Keep the lower ribs hugging in. Demi and up. Demi and up. Nice. And demi. Okay. Arms down to demi second. Here we go. Push into one foot. And squeeze, come up. Really stretch through this foot as it goes down. Use your optimum, your maximum turnout for you. So you might just be here, you might be more turned out, you might have flat turnout. Bend it down. Low as you can without the other heel coming off the floor. Pushing into the toes, a bit quicker here. Down, push. Squeeze inside thighs. Four more. Four. Three. Two. Now I'm going to slow it down, add an arm, little side bend, over and back, over and back. Keep that navel to spine. Good work. Over and back. Reach and press. This will be our last one. Here we go. Reach over. Step to second. Demi plies. Again, turning out from the tops of the legs. Push into the balls of the feet to come up. Lift here, keep the lower ribs down. Lift through the crown of the head, send your buttocks down. Now arms down, lift the one heel up. Lift and push away. And down. And push. So as low as you can go here, keeping the knees in line with your middle toes. Working the inside thighs, not working the knees. For four, and up. Three, and up. Nice here. Two, keep the shoulders down. And one. Squeeze the inside thighs. Let's go quicker, but keep the depth. For eight. Seven. Six. Navel to spine. Four. Three. Squeeze as you come up. Two. One. Slow it down at the side bend. Over. Lift. Over. Lift. Two more of these. Two. And one. Nice. Bring the feet parallel. I'm going to face this way so you can see me better. Straight legs if you can. Hip distance apart. If you need to bend them, bend them. Hold your core. Arms out. Take it forwards and down. So hands to the floor or something in front of you. Now lift your navel towards your spine. Really tilt the hips up, up, up. Good. Bend and stretch. Knees are on the toes. Bend and stretch. Bend. And stretch. Four more. Four. Send the hips up. Three. You can relax your head down if you want to. Keep your core muscles working. Squeeze that pelvic floor up to help lift the hips up. Now rise and lower onto the toes and lower down. Rise and lower. Rise up, lower, up and hold, stay there. Tummy muscles in. Nice, lower the heels, push into the feet, reach forward to come up. Strong core, strong legs, strong core, absolutely. Exhale, and open. Couple of big shoulder rolls here, up and back, and loosen up. Nice work, well done. Okay, straight into our tendus. So we're gonna start in third position today. So I want you to put your right foot in front of the left. Right heel goes to left arch, even turn out. No arms for this. Now really, this will only work if you really pull up your legs. So I need straight legs, not locked. So if you're hypermobile, don't lock them back, but pull it up, engage your quad. Okay, front foot's gonna hold its turn out. So think heel forward, so it's not here, it's turned out. Heel out, squeeze it in, out, in, out, in. We're gonna do loads of them. And then keeping that turn out, keep your core, your lift straight behind you with the other leg. So it's not this, yeah? Keeping both legs working equally. And then we'll change legs. And then we're gonna do it to the side. When we go to the side, we're gonna work from first. Out, in, out, in. My body's not moving, it's not that, okay? Duh, tick-tock. So you're holding your pelvis steady and your spine using your lower abdominals. Good. Let's go for it. Right foot in front. Hold really strong core, this one, shoulders down. Even turn out. If you're used to working from fifth, you do lots of dancing, you can work from fifth. I'm gonna demonstrate in third. Right foot ready to go forward. Here we go. Hold that turn out. Now keep your left leg pulled up as well. Out, in, out, in. Lift through the pelvic floor, navel to spine. Breathe. Four, three, two. We're gonna go straight to left leg at the back. Make sure it's right behind you. What we'll want to, it wants to do this. That works more into the outer hip. We want inside thigh more so. So straight behind you. Keep this front leg pulled up. Shoulders are down. For four, three, two, we're gonna change legs and then left foot to the front. So left foot's in front, keep that right leg pulled up strong, shoulders are down, watch your nut up here, shoulders down. Are you drawing your navel in? Is your right leg pulled up, left leg turned out? For four, three, this is fun. Right leg to the back, right behind you. Everything's working here. You can even smile, work your facial muscles. Pull that leg up. For four, three, two. Take a breath here. Feet to first. Okay, we're gonna do four on each side. Here we go. Four, keep it flexed and turned out. Two, one. Just remember, watch you're not leaning. Just check in with yourself. Am I nice and long, inside thighs working? Four, three. Really flex that foot. Two, one. Four, three. Two, let's take the arms out for a second. For two, one, two, change. Keep that turn out, rotate, rotate. One, two, one. Now with a stretch foot for two, one, two, change. One, two, keep going for eight, change feet. Seven, keep the supporting leg pulled up. Six, navel to spine. Five, four, buttocks and inside thighs and core should be really working. Two, one, and down. Nice work, you did all that, really well done. Okay, little port de bras here for you before we go down. Oh, I've got one more after this before we go onto the mat. We're gonna step the right, the right foot forwards. So with this lunge position, I'm gonna show you from both angles. It's like you're in first position, so you're turned out from here, okay? Both feet are flat on the floor. Right foot forwards, left foot back. So what will want to happen is your back leg will want to do this. So push into the outside of that back leg, left leg for you, yeah? And your, it's like first, so heel opposite heel. And you're rotated, so pull the knees out. Check down, your knees should be in line with your toes, that's really important. So I want you to go wide, it's not here. Yeah, it's wide, we're working into the legs. wide lunge, pushing into that back leg. Arms are out. Now I'm going to push right into the outside of my left leg at the back as I reach forward. So I'm lengthening through my body, but I'm using my core muscles here to help lengthen. After your fifth, and I'm going to come up without lifting the legs and open the back. Now I'm going to do six on each leg, okay? When we come up, they're nice and slow. When we come up from it, if you want to add a little back bend, you can. Keep pushing into the back of that outside leg, that's key. Keep the pelvis square. And then we're going to come into arabesque. So as we lift up, so if you lift up with your right leg, we're going to bring our right arm forwards, left arm to the side. Now get that front body lifted, and we're going to lift that leg up behind us, keeping both legs straight. I'll talk you through that. Oh, yeah, why not? Great for the back body as an arabesque. Here we go. Step your right leg forwards, left leg back. Turning out from the tops of the legs, engage your core. Arms to second. Push into the back leg. Stay there. Now come forwards. Lifting up. And open the chest. Stay deeply bent into your front leg, back leg is straight. Reach forward, navel to spine. Lift up. Open the chest. And again, reach forward. This is number three. Working into the legs. Push into the back of your back leg, your left leg. Open. And again. Reach. Lift up. Strong legs, strong core. Shoulders are down. Relax the face. Two more. Reach forward. Lift up. And open. Last one, navel to spine, reach, push into the outside of your left foot as you reach forward, come up, open. Now stretch that front leg, right arm forward, left arm out, shoulders down, lift the back leg and hold, both legs are straight, stay there, so you're pulling that back leg out of your hip, find length, stretch it, look forwards, and nice work, left foot forwards, right foot back. I'm going to face this way for you this time. Turn out from the tops of the legs. Engage your core. Bend deeply into that left leg. Right leg is straight. Reach forward. Lift up and open. Here we go. Forward. Keep the back leg straight. Lift up. Open. Four more. Forward. Up. And open. And forward. And lift. And open. Stick with me. Reach and forward. And up. And open. Last two. Press into the outside of your right foot. If you lengthen, lengthen, lengthen. Lift up. Open. Last one. Navel to spine as you reach. Lift up. Open. And now lift up. Right leg is straight, sorry, left leg is straight, right leg behind you. Keep the hips hugging in. Left arm forwards, right arm back, shoulders down. Lift that leg up, hold it here. Good, so you don't have to be high, you can be here. Keep the body nice and lifted. Up to you, all work for a bit of height. Lift up that supporting quad. And then lower. Forwards, port de bras, all the way down. Lifting up. Good, step forwards on your right leg. Let's take arabesque again. Lift up, shoulders down, chest forward. Turn that underneath leg out if you can. Breathe. Switch legs. Left leg forwards, right leg back. Lift your core, shoulders down, back leg up. Supporting leg pulled up. Hold it there. And lower, forwards we go. Roll up. And open. Nice work. Okay, let's do a little heart raiser. Little, not too high impact with the jump, so nice soft ones. I'm going to start in first, bend the legs. Little glissade. If you know glissades, feel free to work under, over, from third, fifth, whatever you like. Otherwise, follow me, go from first. So it's like you're jumping over, if you've never done before, jumping over a little puddle. And one, stretch, bend. And two. There's a moment where both feet are going in the air, stretching down, okay? Arms just swing out in. Out in, glissade, like a glide, it means to glide. holding our turnout and going through our feet. So everything we've practiced today. Yeah, nice. A few glissades. And then we're gonna do, just for fun, a little pas de chat. Again, if you're used to working from third, go towards your back foot, otherwise from first, pas de chat, up, up, down. Mean step of the cat. Two one way, and then two the other. So we'll do it without the jump first, just like that, and then we'll add the jump, up, up, down. Up, up, down. So there's a moment where your feet are here, in the air. Follow me. Then we're gonna go to the mats. Honky cat for pas de chat, cat step. Use our arms. Ready, here we go. And one. Stretch, bend. Nice and slow to begin with. Glissade. Stretch, bend. Glissade. Stretch, bend. And glissade. Stretch those legs, turn them out. So it's not this. Hold your side. Glissade. Good, let's speed it up a bit. Glissade. Glissade. Lift, bend. Glissade. Glissade, stretch, bend. Okay, pas de chat, hands to the waist. Up, up, hold to the right. Up, 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 and hold. Once more like that. Left, right, to the other side. Right, left, ending first. Right, left, let's add the jump, here we go. And one, again, and two. We're gonna add a little stretch bend. Take it to the right, pas de chat, stretch, bend. Pas de chat, stretch, bend. High as you can, stretch, bend. If you want to add arms, you've done them before, you can. Stretch, bend. Other one, stretch, bend. Arms are going from third if you're used to using them. If not, keep them here. Pas de chat. Padisha. Last time, glissade. Here we go. Glissade. Stretch. Bend. Glissade. Stretch. A bit quicker. Hold your turnout. Four more. Four. Three. Straight into our padisha. Jumping. One. Two. Switch sides. One. Two again. One. Two. Last set. Ah! Oh, to jump is nice, isn't it? Good. Let's go onto our mat. Just got one on the mat for our core and upper body. I'm going to do a nice stretch. Yes. So, I'm going to start on our bellies for this one. And then we're going to... I don't know how we're going to end this one, but I'll remember as we go along. So we're here. We're looking on our forearms. Have a little upper body stretch to begin with. Then, can you see my feet? I want you to push into your forearms and your tops of your feet and get your hips off the floor. So engage our core, we're gonna lift up here. So it's like a plank, forearm plank, and then lower down. And then lift the chest and lower the head. And then again, using your core, so if you're feeling this in your back, then you're not using your core enough. So lift the pelvic floor, push it into the tops of the feet and the forearms, you're coming up here. Do a few of those. Then we're going to come onto our side, and we're going to step our top leg over like this. Push up either on, if you've got no wrist issues, you can push up to your hand as I'm going to do. If not, stay on the forearm. Otherwise, you're here. And we're going to take that side stretch up and over, and then we're going to hold it up here as we use the arms. Side stretch, sending this hip nice and high, working into the upper body and the abs. Some of you might be able to lift that leg. So really working through the core as well. And we're doing that on both sides. And then we'll end with a couple of press-ups. Nothing to it. Nothing to it. Right, on your tummies. So, elbows are under your shoulders. Feet are hip distance apart. Push into the forearms, draw the shoulders back, lift the chest. Now feel your pelvic floor engaged. You're gently pressing your pubic bone in towards the mat, neck in line with spine. Push into the feet. Here we go. Lift the hips. Hold it here. Slowly lower. Take a breath. And again, just into the arms and the feet, lift the hips, engage the core, and up. Eight more, ready? Eight, hold it, and lower. And again, engage the pelvic floor, navel to spine, and lower. Working into the shoulders as well here, lift up, and lower. Doing awesome. Lifting up, stretch the legs, the quads are working as well. Full body movement, yes, and again, to four. And low. And three. And lower. And again. For two. Squeeze the core, lift the pelvic floor. Last one, we're going to up and hold. Stay there. Hold it. For four, three, two, one. Nice. Come onto your side. Step your top leg over. Push up to here, or your forearm. Shoulders are down, now engage your core here, send your top hip up, arms to the side, you're going to float it over, over, for two, and back. Now I've got four more, if you want to add the leg you can, over, for two, with control, and back, for two, three, and back, use your core, take that arm strength, and down, last one. Three, up for two, and down, good work. Other side, whichever side you didn't do, switch it. Push up, hip high, engage your core. Shoulders are down, take it easy. Arms to the side, here we go. Up, and down for two. Over, for two, and down. Two, four more if you want to add the leg. Up for two, and float down for two. Keep breathing, keep your focus. Up for two, and down. Navel to spine, lengthen your tailbone to your bottom heel. Awesome work. Lift up for two, and down. Last one, here we go, we've got this. Lifting up for two, and down. Wonderful. Stay there, we're going to stretch. Good work. Okay. Wherever you are, come onto your hands and knees. Have a little wiggle wobble. Inhale, your left arm up, open. Exhale, thread the needle, take it underneath, lower your ear to your mat, send your hips back. Oh, breathe into the upper body, you'll twist. In fact, breathe into the whole body. Breathe into the pelvis as well. If you want to, you can extend your top arm to the top of the mat. If that feels good. Gently pushing into the tops of the feet. Expanding on an inhale. Softening on an exhale. And then slowly release. Inhale, right leg, right arm, sorry, open, shoulders down, chest open. Slowly loop it under. Find your thread, the needle, send the hips back. Pelvic floor is engaged. Gentle sways, extend your top arm if it feels nice, if not, stay as it is. And now feel your breath. Slowly unravel. We're going to take pigeon stretch. You bring your right leg underneath and then slowly lower the hips. Go on down if you know what you're doing. If it's not comfortable on your knee, do a reclined pigeon stretch instead. So you're here. Okay, this is your option otherwise. Right ankle over left thigh. If it doesn't feel good on the knee, any discomfort. Otherwise you're here. You can lower the body to the forearms all the way down. Either way, breathing deeply into your hips, into the pelvis. Free the mind. And then pulling up. Take the right foot to the outside of the mat. Lizard pose. Lower the hips. You want to come to your forearms, or you can keep on the fingertips, allow the right knee to open. So move slowly, see what options give you the best stretch. And they want a really good deep stretch that isn't too painful, isn't painful, doesn't feel incorrect. So you're here, or you can come lower, and lower that leg down if you need to. Wherever you are, take a few breaths. And then bring that foot in slightly. Let's stretch our hip flexor and quad. So hands come to the thighs, shoulders down. Gently push into the top of your left foot. Stay here if that's enough. If you want a deeper stretch, some of you might like to take your left or right hand, doesn't matter. Just take hold of the foot. Again, there should be no discomfort in the knees. Wherever you're at, breathe. Relax the shoulders, relax the jaw. Gently release. Let's take the same thing on the other side. So bring your left leg through or go to your back to do recline, thread the needle. If you're on your back, it's left ankle over right side. Inhale, lift, exhale, meltdown. Breathing deeply, soften through the hips. Notice if you're gripping anywhere, through the mind. Two more breaths here. And then picking up, take your left foot to the outside of the mat. So you can either stay here, or you might lower to the forearms, or you might allow that left knee to drop open deeper, or both. Whatever you're doing, move slowly. Find what you feel like you need to do with your body today. And then breathe. You might gently sway into the stretch, you might find stillness. There's no right or wrong with this. Trying not to grip anywhere. Trying to release. Trying to find tension and whoo, let it go. Breathing deeply. When you're ready, bring that left leg in, put ankle underneath. Lift the body by pushing into your right foot. Pelvic floor engaged to support your spine. So you're staying here. Or maybe taking the back foot if that feels good. Find your breath. Notice if you're gripping the hip or thigh here. Try and soften the hip and thigh. Pelvic floor is engaged, that will support your back. But much better to stretch your thigh and your hip when it's not tense, not working. And then release. Good. Come to sitting. Soles of the feet together. Lift up to begin with and then hinge forward. Gentle pressure on the insides of the legs. And then round. Head towards your feet. Roll it up. Keep hold of the ankles. Keep both sit bones down. We're just going to round through the body here, easing through the hips and the lower back. Couple of circles one way. Keep breathing. Should feel really nice after your workout. And then take it the other way. Nice. Take your legs out to second. Reach forward. Find your forward stretch. If you need to prop your hips up onto a pillow or anything, then that's absolutely fine. Do that. Breathe here. Breathing deeply. When you're ready, walk the hands back. Going to find our last posture, our last forward fold. So feet are hip distance apart. Bend as much as you need to, excuse me, to get your torso onto your legs. Take hold of the elbows and have a little sway side to side. Maybe bending one knee, straightening the other, sending the hips up. Now you're nice and warm. feeling it out. Give the head a shake and nod, open, close the jaw. Find stillness. Then walk the hands forward slightly, you can bend the knees if you need to. I'm going to bend into one leg, and so I'm bending my left leg and I'm sending my right hip really high. So you send your right hip high, feel that opening through the outside of the right leg and hip. And switch. And then soften the knees. Let's take a nice slow mindful roll up. Lifting through the core. Big shoulder roll at the top. Breathe in, lift it up. Exhale down. And again, catch something. And let go of something you don't need. Thanks, guys. Thanks for joining. Lots more coming your way.